Hey guys, what's up? Back with some more Dark Souls lore through. I'm gonna clear out Blighttown's base here, collect all the items, and then we're going to get a Quaalug did. Do this fast enough, the Ring of the Evil Eye is gonna make it so that I don't really take a lot of damage from poison. I'm gonna kill these slug things because they can drop, you know. They could drop some green titanite shards, and you never know when you might need some green titanite shards. They can also drop large titanite shards, which I more need. We're gonna come back to Blighttown quite a bit. There's a couple of events here that happen. But for now, we're just gonna collect all the items. Wow, that took like most of my life away. Did not realize they were so dangerous at this stage. Damn, beautiful little ballet with that guy. Just going back and forth. So yeah, I mean, I guess we can talk about Blighttown while we're here. I mean, you know, Blighttown, you know, it kind of, you know, it sounded like they were going from Laura and Deadberg to the depths to whatever, but I mean, Blighttown really was like it has all this poison in it. And that causes a lot of issues, and only certain things can live around here. As you can see, we have new enemies here. Okay. Let's look at this real quick. Server. Her great sword used in a mysterious ancient rite, imbued with a frightful occult energy, which restores HP with each hit. Okay, so that must be what happens in this game, not the. So if it gives you HP on each hit, and it had an ancient rite associated with it, I mean, it's possible that it's linked to Astora and the Ring of the Evil Eye, which has a similar property. Finally, I get something. Five green titanite shards. One of the things that we're gonna do when we come back through is to kind of explore this. This is the Great Hollow here. You can actually see this from Firelink Shrine. Plague Shield. Oh, and we didn't read. I was gonna read a bunch of stuff at the end of last episode, but I forgot. Makeshift shield built from wood planks provides minimal protection, but at a cost of moderate humiliation. I was gonna read Power of Within. Pyromancy of Carmina, who harnessed the power of the flame, actualized the inner self. So yeah, we have yet another Carmina pyromancy that harnesses the inner self. So, I mean, this is the game's best, held secret. But we're not gonna go here now. I just wanted to, I guess I'm already here. I'm not gonna go down, but I'm gonna light the bonfire. Because, why not? But let's head back. Yeah, you can actually see the Great Hall from Firelink Shrine, and we'll take a look at that once we get back there. But this Great Hollow is very important to the lore of the story. And we'll eventually get down there and see what's at the base of it. A little bit of a teaser for now, I guess. Just trying to get as many large Titanite shards as possible. Because the next stage is really going to be to get this Uchi up to its next, to plus 10, which would be nice. I don't think there's anything here, but I don't want to leave anything behind. Okay, I think that's it for this kind of area over here. Hit the bonfire real quick and then explore the other side. But we're definitely gonna figure out why Blight Town has kind of been infested with this poison and why it's home to pyromancers and the like. One of the things that we have to do in order to get that information is to upgrade our pyromancy flame to plus 10, so, or maybe we can get invaded by someone who has that, but I doubt that will happen. That happened in a game of mine not too long ago. And so I was able to get a lot of information. So these guys have a extremely rare weapon. But I don't think I'm gonna. It would be great if I could pick that up. I guess it's not really a weapon. It says it's not a weapon, but you can use it as a weapon. I've leveled it up and used it as a weapon. But maybe we should be lucky. When I was farming the weapon just the other day, actually, for another character, I got two of them dropped by two different those guys over there, actually. What does the Great Cloak say? Probably nothing too exciting. Giant tree branch serves as a wooden club. The leaping attack trademark of clubs, yeah. It's cool. I didn't know it was a tree branch. Will I aggro these guys? I'm assuming so. If not, all the better. So yeah, I guess what I'm gonna do here is I'm just going to, I'm just gonna homeward bone. Because I just wanna refresh my Estus and go straight for the boss. But I think we're done here for now. Oh, did they not kindle us? That's why. I was like, did I really use 10 Estus? Alright. I don't think there's anything we need to do before killing this boss. I mean, you know, I'm missing dialects left and right, but I'm just trying to do, like, an average playthrough of this, in a sense. Where, you know, just playing at least one major way, you know, kind of gives you the story of the game. There's obviously plenty of playthroughs out there that kind of show you every single scenario that can happen. But, you know, I'm probably gonna get a lot of the boss weapons and all that stuff just to, like, get some of those lore, but, for the most part, you know, we're just gonna, I suppose I should minimize how many I have to use here. And now we're in Quailag's domain, and this is a spider hole and all of her eggs up here, and we have the Fair Lady, as being someone who, it's Quailag's sister, the Fair Lady, and that person has worshippers, that have eggs on their back, as they've been affected by the Blighttown pus. And we can summon Maneater Mildred in human form for this. And I'm gonna do that. And I'm gonna try to get Quailag to be less health. Because Maneater Mildred needs all the help she can get. Because she often just gets stuck in the lava. So yeah, I think I'll explain this area a little bit better once I kind of get all the items and talk to everyone here, rather than just explaining what's going on. But anyway, this is Quailag, who has a huge deformation. So yeah, I think, you know, I've always said about Dark Souls to my friends or whatever, there's there's definitely like different areas in which people kind of give up the game, you know, when they're playing for the first time. You know, I think the first is the Asylum Demon, like, just right off the bat, like, if, you know, they can't get through the first boss, it's so tough comparatively to other games. It's like, that's your first moment, you know. Then the next one's probably the Gargoyles. And then it's, probably Quelaag after that. And then it's, undoubtedly Ornstein and Smough. I misread it the one time that I was looking at Maneater Mildred whether she was going to be jumping into the lava. And, indeed she was. And I missed the, area of effect. Never want to miss that. Especially with my health. I maybe should have gone back to the Undead Asylum. Gotten the ring there that helps you run through the swamp. Especially when I have no stamina and rolling is very inconvenient. Okay. Gonna do it without Maneater Mildred this time, see if, maybe I was summoning her with too much health, and maybe it might be a little bit easier this time. Also, she won't distract me. That's for damn sure. I just hate her swings because they kind of have like a little bit of an area. Was a little bit great. I will give you that. Yeah, I think that was gonna be the AoE. But okay, so we do get a soul for Quelaag. By the way, she was very large. I would just say. I mean, the demons were large up until now, but they were the size that they would be, right? And the gargoyles were the size they would be. But this was, I mean, I guess Quelaag herself is kind of human-sized. So maybe don't read into that all that much. But let's see what this says. Soul of Quelaag, once daughter of the Witch of Izalith, but now a chaos demon. Special beings have special souls, and Quelaag's soul contains all aspect of chaos. So yeah, this is the daughter of the Witch of Izalith, which is one of the original finders of the souls in the flame. And the Witch of Izalith has an important role in this whole story when it comes to chaos and, you know, pyromancy in general. But she had seven daughters, or at least seven daughters or something, and we are just meeting Quay Lag, and then we're gonna meet Quay Lana sometime, and now we are going to meet someone known as the Fair Lady, who is also a sister. But there goes the second bell of awakening. I guess we're signaling something to awaken. There's where we fought the gargoyles. There's the back of Sen's fortress. There's a giant. It's the first giant we see in the Dark Souls series. Not the last. And there is the long-awaited gate to Sen's fortress now opened. So that's our next goal. We have a few things to do first, though. Looks like there's something through that wall. This doesn't look like usually the invisible walls look a certain way, but this one really just, like, I don't know. There's no way you would know unless you saw a message. This is Engi. And he has a very specific role in all of this. He's probably single-handedly created Blighttown. Let's see what he has to say.
Oh dear, what have we here? Are you a new servant?
A servant to the Fair Lady, which we can kind of see sticking out of the wall there. Yeah, I guess I'm a new servant.
But you have no eggs. Ha, no matter.
No.
Go along and have audience with our Fair Lady. I pray that you will mind your manners.
I will. Now, so here's another lady that has been warped into the body of a spider or something. And this is Quaylock's sister, as you can probably tell from her appearance. She is unique, though, because she is a firekeeper. And this bonfire is lit already. Let's see if Engi has anything to say.
What is it? Go along and meet our Fair Lady. What is it?
Alright. Now, so basically I took the Old Witch's Ring because I just think it's good for lore. You know, basically the Old Witch's Ring. Old ring from an old witch engraved manually with indecipherable script, but seemingly useless. Well, its use is that you can actually hear our Fair Lady speak. And I think it should be pointed out, because it isn't really revealed till a little bit later. I think actually when you kill her, it's not made completely clear, but she thinks she's talking to... Well, I guess she thinks she's talking to Quaylag, even though it's her mom's ring, but anyway, she thinks we're her sister because no one can hear her normally.
Quaylag.
Oh, there it is.
My dear sister.
Yeah, once again, what I say is immediately confirmed. I should just wait and talk about it afterwards.
Quaylag, what is it?
So again, she can reinforce the Essence Flask because she is a Firekeeper. We don't have any Firekeeper souls. She has a Covenant, which is the Covenant I think that Kirk is actually part of. But I can't be sure. And I'm going to enter that, actually.
Enter a Covenant again. Of course. Let me try.
Interesting. Because doing this Covenant will help with Solaris questline, actually. So, Great Chaos Fireball. Oh, yeah. So it's a Pyromancy, but it deals with chaos. And yeah, you have offer humanity to her to gain ranks in the Covenant. And that's why I was saying earlier that I think that, you know, humanity itself is kind of viewed as a savior as well, because it's associated with so many different covenants. Alright, let's see what she has to say.
Quaelag, my dear sister, the eggs, it hurts. They've gone still. I am afraid it may be too late. I am so sorry, dear sister. I'll be fine. I have you, dear sister, but promise me that you will take care of yourself.
It's funny how something like this can make you feel a little bit like this is some deformed, twisted creature created from some ungodly ritual. Yet, she's in pain and she's confused, and the eggs that she used to birth are dead, and she's trying to take comfort in just what is her sister, of course, who we just found to be adversarial and we killed. Just interesting to me because this game can touch on some really interesting notes sometime. It's dark fantasy, but it also has such humanity in it.
I'll be fine, but promise me that you will take care of yourself. Goodbye, Quaelag. Do be safe.
When was the last time that Quaelag could have fit in this room?
You speak the tongue of the fair lady?
I do.
Well, do not be rash with your pride. You have yet to earn my trust. If you try anything funny with the fair lady, there will be hell to pay.
I'm wondering if I should just waste these souls on the pyromancy flame so we can get the let's do it. 9, okay. Let's see what he's got for sale. Servant rosters, check servants of the Daughters of Chaos. That's the covenant I just entered. Egg Bear Engi keeps this roster of those who serve his master, a Daughter of Chaos. Engi praises those who offer significant humanity to alleviate his master's suffering. But what is praise from Engi really worth? I would say he's a cool guy, but probably not worth that much.
There is no time for idle chat. Think only of our fair lady and what she may need.
Yeah, humanity, I get it.
There is nothing to say to you, except if you should be prepared to face my wrath.
I mean, I guess technically he does, you know, cause an issue here. If you try to fight him, because he's got infections and whatever. But, I mean, come on, what are you going to do to me? Alright, well, let's actually start by giving some humanity. I'm going to keep some. This is not the most interesting part part of the game, but I mean, let's at least level up to the first rank. And then I think Engi might speak to us differently. And even then, after that, we're gonna go and get infected by an egg sack. And I definitely think he talks to us differently then. Okay. Also, let us... Man, we might have enough to... Definitely to get to the next pyromancy stage, but we might even get... We might be able to max it out. I would hope that we can, because... That would save us some time. I mean, we're coming back down to the, Blight Town anyway, but, you know, it's like, while we're here learning about the Daughters of Chaos, and Quail Egg, and the Fatal Lady, and Engi, and all this stuff, it would be great to just, I guess I shouldn't go too crazy here, let's just see what we need.
You. Well, if you try anything.
Yeah, you told me. Oh yeah, 12,000. There you go. Never done this so quickly.
You.
Yeah.
If you.
There we go. I think it's only plus 10. Dang, I didn't realize it goes up to 15.
Oh my dear sister, don't mind me.
Doesn't hurt terribly. Okay. I think they should have just made this so that you can, you know, dump 30 in there real quick. Yeah. So yeah, I guess, you know, we're gonna have to go get infected before we can get anything from Engi, before he'll sell us his pyromancies. And, we can do that outside, so that's not that big of a deal. But, and I have to do this. I'll do it off camera probably at the time just to help with the quest, but I have to do this 20 more times in order to unlock one of the doors that really helps me out. Check and see if Quailana is there. And it might be plus 15. I did not check before. Demon ruins, so we're going closer and closer into the heart of something's got. Oh wait, did I rest at that bonfire? That would be unfortunate. Indeed, tis. check on. Ugh. And look at that. It is plus 10. Okay, I think the mosquitoes stop bothering you. If you talk to her, but I'm not sure. Oh, well, I didn't talk to her. But... Okay, yeah. Here's another Izalith daughter. By the way, I think Izalith is the name of the original Witch of Izalith. I think her name was Izalith, and they named the area after her. Now, notably, this sister is not a terrifying demon.
A mere undead, yet you can see me. Fascinating. I am Quelana of Izalith. I am not often revealed to walkers of flesh. You have a gift. Are you too one who seeks my pyromancy, like Salomon?
Aha. So, we know that Salomon was the master pyromancer, the father of pyromancy, maybe, and taught Carmina and, you know, a lot of other people. I think even Laurentius says that he might have studied with Salomon. Salomon is very, very old, of course, though. But Salomon approached Quelana and asked for her help, and I'm going to do the same.
Yes, of course. It should be expected. Very well. You shall be my pupil. But to pursue my pyromancy, you must give something up. Are you prepared to do this?
Perhaps the whole thing with pyromancy becoming a, you know, master-pupil relationship, and, you know, saying you got to give something up, give a piece of you, fires a piece of you, nature, all this stuff. Maybe that all stems from Quelana and the way that she thinks about it. I mean, it might come from Izalith and how she thinks about it. But we know that all the things that have happened, we certainly know that things happened thousands and thousands of years ago. I mean, we'll come up against a lot of that information later, but I mean, this stuff is ancient, so the fact that Quelana is sitting here as one of the original daughters of Izalith is interesting about, you know, on death and how long old people live in this world. And she can go up our souls. Let's look at what she has. So she's got the fireball, she got the great fireball. Salomon, the master pyromancer, also called the great fireball after this spell, believed pyromancy was rooted in an adoration of fire. Those who acquire this spell usually agree. Firestorm. Primal pyromancy taught by Quelana of Izalith wrecked fire pillars in the vicinity. The storm of flame is indiscriminate and incinerates all nearby life. Fire whip. The root pyromancy of combustion. So, like other things, like miracles, and like we'll see with sorceries, I mean, there are original pyromancies, and then there's bastardizations of them, or variations on them, or something. Because it's being handed down. Combustion, we read about that. Great combustion. Advanced pyromancy of Quelana of Izalith. Charm undead and gain temporary allies. The living are lured by flame. And this relationship is part and parcel to the art of pyromancy. It can be used by either gender. Oh, thank you very much. I've never used this, but I would be very curious as to see how you can charm the undead and gain allies. I should look that up. Fireball, of course. Okay. Nothing else? No. Okay, what do you have to say, Quelana? How did all this come to be?
Long ago, I accepted another pupil like yourself. Over 200 years ago, there was a man almost as bungling as you. In your world, he was called Saloman, the Master Pyromancer. The little rascal really made something of himself.
Okay, I mean, again, I should probably just wait until people talk, but yeah, so we learned that, Saloman is came to Earth 200 years ago. I mean, who knows where Saloman is right now, but she's over 200 years old for sure.
Pyromancy is the art of invoking and manipulating fire. But remember one thing. Always fear the flame, lest you be devoured by it and lose yourself. I would hate to see that happen again. Pyromancy is the art of invoking, but remember, always I would hate. No luck. Well, young pupil, you must have patience, but do not keep me waiting much.
Let's buy something, I guess. I'd be interested in an undead rapport if we can get enough souls for it. One thing I like about this game is you don't have to buy everything in order to, I don't think we're gonna get any. So close.
Ah, I was expecting you. Pyromancy is the-
Okay.
I would hate-
Fire Orb is 8,000, I didn't really realize that. I mean, I guess let's buy a couple of these. I mean, combustion's good. Great combustion, sure. Fireball. I guess we can't buy any more, but maybe she'll talk to us now.
Now go. Whatever you do, do not crack and go hollow, lest my time spent on you be wasted.
Well, I owe it to her.
Ah. I applaud your diligence, but what have you brought for me?
Nothing now, but...
Pyromancy is...
I seem to recall much more stories,
no luck.
So...
Well, but do...
I would hate to have to buy everything of hers in order to... I will try to go and get infected by the eggs, and then I will read up on stuff before I continue. Just trying to grasp at straws here. I'm gonna make sure to rest at that bonfire this time so I don't have to run back and forth. But yeah, I mean, I guess the next area is Sin's Fortress that we're gonna do. So I'll do this here, and then I guess we're just gonna cut and then I'll just go to Sin's Fortress that time, and we can get to that and maybe get to Orlando tomorrow. Sin Fortress, it's usually not a big deal for me. Alright. I guess I was thinking those guys would suck my brains out, but maybe I need to go down to this boy. This boy over here. have to get, like, to bite on my head, or does that count? Can't get too hurt. I really thought it like grabbed you. Here, I'll kill one of these guys. Oh. Hope I didn't know if you could get grabbed by them or not, like if that would cause me to die. Stop grabbing me. I just need. Okay, I hope that did it. But I guess that's what you need to do. You need to get grabbed by them. Seems like, seems like a, sorry, I'm just waiting to see if I scratch my head. It seems like a fairly difficult thing to get. I mean, I guess this is supposed to be very, like, you know. Oh, still one left. Oh, they're worse than dogs. Oh my god. I just need the one. Maybe I can kick one of these guys up here and have them, like, be aggro against me. Okay, that'll be a little bit easier. Grab me. Be a perfect distance away. Do I have to be facing backwards? Okay. Oh, I guess I should have healed first. Oh, God. Oh no. Okay, well, I mean, that really looked like it got to me, and then I didn't die. There we go. Okay, so now I'm scratching the back of my head. I'm not sure if I need to feed it souls, if it's just a matter of time, but I certainly am not going to try to fight those guys in an effort to get more souls, because that is just not going to be worth my time. This will be the last thing we do here. scratching your head. Be a shame if your head turned into an egg. There's a great holo, by the way. Oh, those are weird textures, actually. But there's the great holo, and up there is Firelink, so. But it's interesting, when I'm scratching my head, I can't move. Like, once I start the animation, I can't, like, start walking when they start scratching. So yeah, now I should. I don't know enough about this to talk very intelligently about it, but I think it's, like, there's a parasite in my head right now, and, I think I get half souls, you know, like, it feeds, I guess those guys normally give you 200, but, yeah, okay, there we go. So I think it was just time. So yeah, now I've turned into an egghead as Engi wants me to do. Does Quelana say anything about this?
Ah, truth be told. The Witch of Izalith.
Oh, here we go.
Please, do not speak of her. I abandoned my mother and sisters and fled to this land. Now I roam these parts feigning ablution. And pretending to seek answers.
Now she's gonna talk to us about it.
Pyromancy is the art.
Oh, God.
I would hate. No luck. But do not keep me with. Ah, I was Pyromancy is.
Okay. Well, I have no idea. What I do know is that Engi is going to talk to us now, and he's going to sell us a lot more stuff, because I know that he sells us the thing that gets rid of this egghead. It should be noted that I can no longer kick. They make weird noises. When I try to do a kick here, I'll do it in the arena so you can see it better. When I kick, oops, that's not what I meant to do. I meant to do this. Oh, I guess it's now it's starting to absorb souls, and then it when it gets to a certain point, then I'll, like, a maggot sticks out of it, and then when I kick, it'll bite. I'm not going to go that far. That's like 10,000 souls or 100,000 souls or something. Okay, that makes more sense. I only need the egg so that I can talk to Engi. And I guess this gains us full trust, or maybe we need to level up the Fair Lady a little bit more. Gonna rest here just in case something terrible goes wrong. Alright, Engi, help me.
Well, now, you're just like me. Your dedication is fully apparent. Only, well, your head looks awful. Why not try this? I've no use for it any longer.
Egg vermifuge.
Oh, hello. What is it that you need?
Now you like me. Bitter sour chestnut removes parasitic egg from the body. The egg bearers have chosen to serve the flame of chaos, and the egg symbolizes selfless choice. Naturally, these chestnuts are forbidden, but are allowed under special circumstances. Then we get to learn about poison and toxic mists. Unique pyromancy crafted by Engi, considered to be a heretic even at the Great Swamp. Engi became an egg-bearing undead who serves a deformed young girl who speaks in an unintelligible tongue. Well, unintelligible to most. Toxic mist. Unique pyromancy crafted by Engi, considered a heretic even at the Great Swamp. Why was Engi driven from the Great Swamp? One only need cast this pyromancy, a perverse diversion from the art of fire, to find out.
Incidentally, do you have an interest in pyromancy? If you have, I shall share my flame with you. You have served our fair lady well. Now, let this strength be yours. In all honesty, I am envious. What comfort can I offer without speaking her tongue? Worse than undead, we are diseased and unwanted, like the grime of the Great Swamp. But my dear, fair lady, she cried for me and swallowed the great blight pus, despite Mistress Quellag's orders to the contrary.
Okay, so before we continue down this story, I just want to share my opinion on this stuff. So, I mean, I believe that the blight pus is a creation of Engi's in some way. I mean, I don't think we learned too much about it. Maybe it's not. Maybe it's just a random thing. Maybe it's related to the chaos. But I believe that, you know, he was a heretic even in the Great Swamp, a land of pyromancers. I mean, even a pyromancer such as Carmina, who, created very alternative pyromancies. And here we have someone who's dealing with poison and toxic and terrible things, who potentially, created the blight pus and, poisoned all of Blighttown in a freak accident. And, then we have the fair lady who wasn't always as incapacitated. In fact, it looks like she probably was very similar to Quellag, as they were demons before Blighttown. I mean, they were demons from the chaos. But she sacrificed herself, as is such with chaos, as is such with pyromancy. I wonder if anyone thinks that Engi is Saloman, like that he's an old pyromancer and he got infected and then no one knows where he is anymore. Huh, I don't know. We'll have to get some pyromancies from Saloman to maybe tie some things together or not.
Worse than unlike the but my dear, and swallowed the great blight pus, despite Mistress Quellag's.
Yeah, so Quellag didn't even want her to do it.
Oh, Helen, what is it that...
Well...
Worse than...
Yeah, okay. Let's see if she says anything to us.
Quellag. Quellag, why did you know your beautiful, silky face? If only I could gaze upon it once more. I'll be fine, but that you...
Okay.
Goodbye, Quellag.
Now is the time where we use the egg permafuge. Eat that beautiful chestnut. All right. For now, that is Blighttown. We will come back. We will go to the Great Hollow. We will meet some characters down in the swamp. We will probably talk to Quellana again. But for now, before we go through the demon ruins and before we come back around here, we are going to go back up and probably explore the loose ends, so to speak. Probably start in Firelink and go down to Valley of Drakes and stuff like that. So, thanks for watching. Talk later.